VO2 max. Notice what is VO2 max? The VO2 max is the maximum oxygen consumed from the individual who's doing extensive aerobics training. And it's also the standard which athletes are compared. What type of athletes are we talking about here, Luke?
Sure, some of these elite athletes compete in Olympic swimming, football, tennis, cyclists. They all measure their peak performance through the VO2 max.
Have you ever wondered why your sports performance is not improving? Maybe it's the lack of intensity in your workouts. Well, Luke, knowing your VO2 max can take you to that higher level. Luke, what are the key benefits of knowing your VO2 max?
Some of the benefits include increasing your heart muscle, also improves your stroke volume.
It increases hemoglobin to your red blood cells and decreases hypertension.
It improves your respiratory efficiency.
All these benefits can help you live a quality and quantity of life. Luke, there's many ways of testing your VO2 max. We have the Bruce Protocol test, or as people know, the treadmill test, the YMCA test, or the cycle test.
However, we're going to administer two tests. We're going to administer the 1.5 mile run test and also the 1 mile walk test. Got
it. Welcome to my gym, the R.G. Gordon Memorial Park.
Today, we're going to talk about VO2 max. We're going to administer two tests in order to get your VO2 max. We're going to administer the 1.5 mile run test and also the 1 mile run test.
One lap at this park is considered a half a mile. So total, I'm going to be running it 3 laps. Here goes nothing. Ready?
Not enough. Nobody said this stuff makes any sense. We're hooked again. The point of no return. See how the buildings burn, light up the night. Such pretty sight.
Is it important to let you know what your set point is health-wise? I'm not an athlete, never was, never will be. But Father Ty kept knocking on my door, and I'm not letting him in yet. At age 43, I'm still going strong. So this message is for you guys, you know, just sitting down, just relaxing all day, just not doing anything. I urge you to stand up after you watch this video, and just start walking. Soon enough, it'll turn into a jog. Do nothing. Turn into a little spray. Thank you so much. Amen.
Boom.
It's not saying like recording.
Yeah, I say 47 right there. Okay, so it's already recording.
You could just start recording.
Okay, Ernie just completed his 1 minute. Hope you enjoy it, and we'll see.
Woo, I don't know what that man had for breakfast, but I want some. Always important to keep in mind is before you do these exercises, to do a 5-minute warm-up session. And after the exercise, 5 to 15-minute cool down. This helps lower the heart rate. Keep that in mind.
Well, let's go through the factors for the 1-point mile walk test. One of the factors is the age. The age will be 43. The weight, 87 kilograms. Remember to convert your pounds into kilograms. The gender here is male. The time was 9.66. Remember also to convert your seconds into minutes. The beats, the heartbeat, it's 1.52 beats per minute. Ernesto, what's going on with the math over here?
Now, I'll show you not. This is not our idea. This formula that you see up on the board is not our idea. We actually got it from my ACSM book here in class. So don't shoot us, please. Lou, at this point, all you're going to do is plug and chug the numbers. We're going to put in my weight, which is 87 kilograms. The age is 43. The gender, last time I checked, I'm a male. Now, if you're a female, you want to put 0, right? That space right there. The time is 9.66, and the heart rate is a 152. Now, you do all these pretty calculations, Lou. It came down to a 52.4, which Lou is.
It's categorized as an excellent.
Woo!
Okay, so we just went through the 1-mile walk test. This over here is the 1.5-mile run test. Some of the factors to consider here are Ernesto's time. Ernesto's time here was 11.4. His VO2 max was a 43.7 according to the Fitness and Wellness book. It is categorized a 39 to 44, which is considered to be a good.
I'm in the red.
Yes. Remember, to monitor your improvements, these are the general rules you must follow. Shoot for a 60-minute workout at a 70% heart rate max. Less than that, you will not see any improvements.
Retest your VO2 max every 3 months to track your improvement. In fact, it's never too late, Lou, to work on your VO2 max. Stand up right now, walk to that stop sign and back. Who knows, Lou, that little walk turned into a little jog. That jog will eventually turn into a sprint. Again, I'm Ernesto.
This is Louis.
Signing off.
Go for it. Go, go, read, film it.
Ready to, okay, ready.
No, no, that's fine.
Hi, I'm Bob Ripley, and I'm here to talk about VO2 max. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, we all going to start with ATP. ATP, okay? We know what that stands for. Never mind, ATP. We look over here, CRP. We know what that stands for, CRP? CRP. And we just keep walking, okay? We got to connect the two dots. ATP eventually turns to iced tea. Okay? Ice T will turn to JZ. You with me so far? Oh, stop it. You got it. AJD. All right, we're going to CRP. Then eventually turns to CPR. CPR. You know what that stands for? Oh, you got that. And then that eventually turns to R. Kelly. R. Kelly. You're not getting it? What, you in class for one? You, oh God, I can't turn to Kelly Rollins. Kelly Rollins, you know how to spell Rollins? Oh God, Rollins. Jay-Z would turn to the General Lee. Dukes of Hazzard? Oh God, never mind. Oh, you know how to spell that. Kelly Rollins, the General Lee, will have a baby and it'll become Bruce Lee. Bruce Lee, you know who Bruce Lee is, boy? Question? Shut up! Science! Boom!
Is that in the syllabus?